Hey, fabulous superstar scientists. Here we go. We're going to take another space journey, and this time we're going to be learning about meteors. So be ready to take some notes while you're on this journey with me. Put your notes in your journal. If you don't have your journal, totally fine. Just put your notes on notebook paper, and we'll add it to your journal later. I have tried to make your note-taking easier by highlighting in red the main ideas, and that is what you can write down as your notes. But remember, the rest of the information is just as important. It helps you understand the main idea notes you're writing down. So moving on, just make sure that you are really paying attention. So by the end of this journey together, you can answer these three questions. What are physical properties of meteors? Where are they located? And this is a really key important question, because where a meteor is located in space actually changes its name. So stay tuned. And also, how do they move about in our solar system? So let's get started. So we're going to actually start out in space, where comets and asteroids are orbiting the sun. When comets and asteroids are orbiting the sun, sometimes small particles of them will fall off, and that's what we call a meteoroid. All right. So when it's out in space orbiting the sun, it's just broken off from a comet or asteroid. We call it a meteoroid. So look at that roid at the end of meteoroid and that roid at the end of asteroid, and maybe that will help you remember. That's when you call it a meteoroid, when it's out in space floating around like comets and asteroids do. Now, once a meteoroid changes from orbiting the sun and begins to make a journey towards the Earth, because it's gotten off of that orbital path, it begins to travel towards the Earth, and that is when we call it a meteor. This is the word you're used to calling it, but it's only called a meteor when it is coming into the Earth's atmosphere and it starts burning off and vaporizing because it's hit our atmosphere. And that's why we call it a shooting star, because this kind of looks like fire and stuff coming off of it. That's the burning off of the actual rock material as it's burning off in our atmosphere. That light, again, is that friction from the meteoroid and our atmosphere combining. And just keep in mind, shooting stars are not really stars. They're actually the rocks, the meteoroid space rocks, being burned up in our atmosphere. Our atmosphere is really designed to protect our planet. So if something tries to come into it, it will most likely burn up and not hit our Earth and hurt us. And that is what typically happens to a meteor. Most of them will burn up before they ever hit the Earth. However, sometimes they do hit the Earth. And once a meteoroid has come through into its journey into the Earth's atmosphere, which then it becomes a meteor, and then it lands on the Earth, it's called a meteorite. I remember meteorite because it ends in T-E, and that's what I remember landing on the Earth. Little trick. Always trying to find a trick to help remember it. And that is truly a meteorite. So if you were to ever find one on the ground, don't call it a meteor, call it a meteorite. Now, sometimes a meteorite can make an impact when it lands on the Earth. And when it lands on the Earth, no matter how big it is, it is called a crater. If it's a pretty big meteorite, it can make a really big bowl-shaped depression, got like a raised rim like these this side right here. Could be smaller, could be different sizes, but those are called crater or meteorite craters. So just keep that in mind. Those are the biggest parts of the notes here. I want to show you another slide just to remind you again. I really, really like this picture because it kind of summarizes what you need to remember. So first we have asteroids and comets out in space orbiting the sun. Sometimes pieces come off of those asteroids and they begin to float off around orbiting the sun, and we call those meteoroids. So meteoroids are almost like really, really much smaller asteroids. So again, you've got that roid-roid connection. Now, once that meteoroid hits the Earth, travels towards the Earth and hits the Earth's atmosphere and starts to burn and look like a shooting star, we call it a meteor. right? Now, once that meteor then actually lands on the Earth's surface, we call it a meteorite. That's it. That's as simple as our notes get today. So, but I do have some extra information here for you that is pretty fun that you can look at. Here's some information about the Russia meteor. In 2013, one actually entered the Earth's atmosphere and turned into a meteor. But the atmosphere actually did its job, so it never hit the Earth, so it did not become a meteorite. The interesting thing about this in 2013 is that the sixth grade science team at the time at Draper, on the day that happened, they were going to teach about comets, asteroids, and meteors. Was that not the most crazy coincidence? So you can watch a video below right here about what happens when that meteorite explodes before hitting the ground. So that's pretty cool. Fun little video there for you. And another one to talk about is the Wisconsin meteor. In 2017, there was a meteoroid out there in space orbiting the sun, entered the Earth's atmosphere and turned into a meteor. And looks like it did the same thing. I see this still says Russia. It looks like these notes need to be updated. The meteorite was coming in and it did not hit too hard. So, but there is a video here to talk about the Wisconsin meteor. And this, again, was a coincidence because the sixth grade science team at that time was about to teach about the solar system. So pretty cool coincidence there. So, but that's it. Pretty simple. Real quick and simple notes about first it's a meteoroid, then it's a meteor, then it's a meteorite. Meteoroid, when it's orbiting the sun out there by the comets and asteroids. Meteor, when it is traveling towards Earth and comes through the Earth's atmosphere and burns up, and that's when we usually see a shooting star, or we call it a shooting star. And then if it actually survives our Earth's atmosphere and actually lands on the Earth's surface, that's when we call it a meteorite. That's simple. All done. Thanks for staying tuned. Hope you got those notes down. See you next time.